Memorial Secondary School. Cape Drama by Free E. Heidi.
Chen Pui Wan is the guy.
Lu Hiu Ying is Kara and Alice.
Huang Chi Kun is Heidi.
Yu Wen Yi is Peter and the servant.
Lu Man Hu is grandfather.
Once upon a time, there was a little girl called Heidi who lived with her aunt Alice. She was a poor orphan with a kind heart. Her aunt did not like her by heart and was not willing to look after her. One day, early in the morning,
"Come on, Heidi, pack up your things."
"What's going on?"
"Hurry up. I'm going to take you up the mountain to see your grandfather."
"See my grandfather?"
"Yes. I need to go to work in Frankfurt and you are going to live with him."
"My grandfather? How old is he? Where does he live? Who lives with him?"
"Shut up, Heidi. Don't ask so many things. You'll find out when you see him, okay?" "Heidi, get off the carriage. Here we are."
"Woo, so beautiful."
"Anyone here?"
"What's the matter?"
"This is Heidi. She is going to live with you from now on. You are her grandfather, so you have the responsibility to look after her. Here are all her things. I have to leave now."
"You are Heidi, aren't you? Let's go into the house first." "How old are you?"
"I'm 6 years old."
"Are you thirsty? Do you want some fresh goat milk?"
"Goat milk? Yes, please."
"Here you are, Heidi."
"Thank you. It tastes very good."
"Hey, I brought back the ghost, Grandpa. Who's that girl?"
"She's Heidi."
"Hello, Heidi. Nice to meet you."
"Hello, Peter. Nice to meet you."
"Why are you here? How old are you? How long will you stay?"
"I will live with Grandpa from now on."
"Peter, you are so talkative. Aren't you have to back home?"
"Oh, it's late. I have to leave now." "Ah, Heidi, do you want to go with me up the pasture tomorrow?"
"Up the pasture? But can I?"
"Off you go."
"That's good. See you tomorrow."
"I'm going to prepare the dinner. You can look around the house."
"I love the hayloft up there. Can I make my bed in the hay?"
"All right."
Heidi was excited and tired. She soon fell asleep in her new soft hay bed. Next morning,
"Hey, Peter, good morning."
"Morning, Heidi. Let's go now, shall we?"
"Yes, Grandpa, we go now."
"Take care yourself."
"Okay."
Peter and Heidi had a very happy afternoon on the mountain. Day after day, they became more and more friendly. But one day,
"I want to take Heidi to Frankfurt with me. I know a man who has a sick daughter. He is looking for a friend to be with her. I am going to take Heidi there."
"Go away. Heidi is happy and won't go with you."
"But she is a big girl now. She must go to school. Come on, Heidi."
"No, I like living here. I want to go away."
"Come on, Heidi. You're not yet."
"But can I come back here if I want?"
"Yes, yes. Now come on, or we'll miss the train."
And so, Heidi went with her aunt to Frankfurt. They went to the house where the sick girl, Clara, lived.
Hello, I'm Heidi. Nice to meet you. What's your name?
Hello, I'm Clara. Nice to meet you too.
Why do you sit in this chair all day long?
Because I can't walk.
Clara was very pleased to have a friend to talk to because she is so lonely. But the servant who looked after Clara did not like Heidi.
You are so rude. I'll have to teach you some manners.
The servants talked on and on, but it had been a long day for Heidi. She went to sleep in her chair.
You naughty girl! How can you be like this?
Next day, Heidi looked out of the window.
There is no trees or flowers, but only streets and shops. Although I like Clara, I don't like here. I miss Grandpa, Peter, and the trees on the mountain. I must go home.
Every night, Heidi dreams that she was at home in the mountain. And one day,
Clara, I have seen a white thing walking outside the corridor. I'm sure it is a ghost.
But I don't think there are ghosts in the world. Let's hide inside a room and wait for it tonight.
And that night, they really find the right thing and...
Oh, Heidi, it's you.
Heidi, you naughty child. What are you doing here? Don't pray anymore. Go to bed immediately and... Heidi.
She is still sleeping. Call our daughter.
The doctor said that Heidi was homesick and she better go home.
Oh, Heidi, it's you. How wonderful to have you back.
It's so surprising and delight to see you again.
It's good to be home. They are kind to me there, but I missed you too and everything here. I would like to get water from the riverbank, milk from the goats, and drink the fresh goat milk. Oh yes, I also miss my hay bag. I know I'll have a nice dream every night.
You always bring happiness to us, my dear Heidi.
Hey, Peter, you see, the letter from Clara. She said that she's coming to see us. I won't go up the mountain with you tomorrow. I would like to wait for her.
Oh, you won't come tomorrow? You like Clara very much, right?
Yes, and I miss her very much.
Heidi, you see who's coming?
Oh, Clara!
Heidi! Ah, here is very beautiful.
How long will you stay?
I can stay here for the whole summer.
Oh, that's great! I'm sure you will like here. You come with me. There are many ghosts in the ghost house. They are very funny.
Oh, ghosts? Let's go.
That night, the two girls slept together in the hayloft. They were very happy together, but there was one who felt unhappy. That was Peter. He was jealous. He missed Heidi, but she spent all her time with Clara. The next day, Peter came to get the goats. He saw Clara's wheelchair by the house.
Nobody would know if I pushed the chair down the mountain. Let's do it and then run it off.
Grandpa, can Clara go up to the pasture?
Yes, I will push her up in her chair. Oh, but where is her wheelchair?
Where's my chair? This was just outside the house before.
Oh, I can't find it.
I carry you up to the pasture first, and then I went down to look for you. Come on, Clara.
Hey, Peter, follow us.
The three children had a happy day on the pasture.
go and have a look on the flowers over there.
Wait here with Peter and the ghost, Clara. I will be back soon.
Oh, the flowers are so beautiful. I'd like you to see them, Clara.
Come on, Peter, you must help me. Let's try to carry her.
Oops, you two are not strong enough. I try to help by putting my feet down. Oh, look, I can walk.
Oh, excellent.
Hey, Grandpa is coming. Grandpa, Clara can walk.
Oh, that's amazing. Congratulations, Clara. But let me carry you down to the house first. You can't walk for so long at once. You should practice walking every day. I'm sure you can walk very well afterwards.
I'm sorry, Clara.
Sorry for what?
I have pushed your wheelchair down the mountain, and I'm very sorry about that.
Never mind, Peter. I can walk now, and I have to say thank you to you. Thank you, Peter.
Hey.
That's all right now.
Every day, Clara started walking. After she went back to Frankfurt, she could go to school and did her study. She enjoyed the school life very much. Heidi also enjoyed her life in the mountain. When there was a holiday, Clara would go to the mountain and live with Heidi. All of them lived happily. Everyone had a happy ending. You see the wonder of a fairy tale. You can take the future, even if you fail. I believe in angels, something good in everything I see. I believe in angels. Time is right for me across the stream. I have a dream. Oh, yeah.
Hey, Mother. I need to go to work in Frankfurt, and you are going to live with him.
My grandfather. How old is he? Where does he live?
Hi, get up. She's going to leave with you from now on. You are her grandfather, so you have the responsibility to. She must go to sleep.
Ups. You two are not strong enough. I'll try to help by putting my feet down.
Oh!
I'm very sorry about that. Never mind, Peter. I can walk now. And I have to say thank you to you. Thank you, Peter.
Please.
After she went back to Frankfurt, she could go to school and did her studies. She enjoyed the school.